Now I am pleased to call on Dr. Scott Rudloff, the Director of PMA 2020, to introduce the winners of the Excellence in Leadership Award for Family Planning, the Excell Awards. Scott.
Thank you, Ouyang. Good afternoon, everyone. It is a distinct honor and privilege for me to present the 2016 Excellence in Leadership for Family Planning Awards. The Excell Awards provide an opportunity to celebrate great progress and honor the achievements being made within our community to increase access to and use of voluntary family planning information and services. These achievements hold valuable lessons for those within and beyond the borders of their respective countries and regions. Lessons for advancing our common goal of providing full access, full choice. Awards are given at three levels: the individual or team level, the organizational level, and the country level. Nominations for these awards were submitted by supporters of family planning within our community from across the world. This year, over 100 nominations were received across these three award categories. A special awards committee comprised of a diverse cross-section of our community reviewed these nominations and made selections based on predefined criteria. Here to join me today in presenting the awards are Ibu Ambar Rahayu, Deputy Chair of BKKBN, and Michael Clagg, Dean of Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health. Please join me on the stage. The first Excell Award is a team award, and it is given to, drum roll please, thank you. This was not rehearsed. The team award is given to Dr. Janette Garin and Congressman Edcel Lagman, Philippines. We are pleased to honor former Congresswoman and newly appointed Health Secretary Janette Garin and Congressman Edcel Lagman for their tireless efforts in introducing, defending, and guiding the enactment of and the sustained implementation of the Responsible Parenthood and Reproductive Health Law in the Philippines. This law encompasses three essential provisions: maternal health, family planning, and comprehensive sexual education for adolescents. These two champions introduced and pushed the bill in their respective political parties and against the powerful opposition in the House of Representatives for a total of 9 years and three congressional terms. Both were targets of intense political attacks for their support for reproductive health and rights. But they never wavered. Instead, they served as rallying points for the Reproductive Health Bill's national campaign. Upon passage of the law in 2012, Congressman Lagman, as a legal luminary, continues to defend it in the face of ongoing threats to undermine it, while Dr. Garin, as Department of Health Secretary, is working to fast-track its implementation. We commend their steadfast and extended commitment to the Responsible Parenthood and Reproductive Health Law and their drive to never give up, even in the face of extreme opposition. Their work has and will continue to inspire all of us and will benefit the lives of millions of Filipino families. I invite you to join me in congratulating Dr. Janette Garin and Congressman Edcel Lagman.
When I receive an email that myself and Congressman Lagman will be given an award, I start thinking, can I simply consider this as a reward? And mind you, when we were fighting for the passage of the reproductive health law, there were a lot of misinformation, a lot of negative campaign against us. Many were accusing me as an abortionist. There were pictures of me on the website, burning in hell, and I started asking myself, can I at least dream that I'll be an angel? Despite all those bad publicities, I know that I was doing the right thing. And your presence here today gives me that inspiration that I can be an angel to spread the message of reproductive health. Hence, we do not look at this as a mere reward, but a constant reminder that there is no time for complacency in this fight for a better quality of life for our women, our children, and our families. There is no time to wait. Yesterday was the time to act. Now is the time to be more aggressive, speak up, be felt, and be heard. Despite the challenges that will come across our way, be it global or national, let us always remember that the force will always be with us. And by force, I meant fostering an obligation and responsibility towards children and equitable opportunity for a better quality of life. Together, let us continue walking the talk, delivering with a force, because not even a tsunami can divert us from what we are doing, because we are doing not only the good thing and the right thing, we are doing because it is a highly moral legacy that we can leave to the future generations. To the young population, you are our future. Keep fighting, keep on walking and to the talk, and keep on delivering. May the force be with you. Thank you.
Family planning dates back to antiquity. Jonathan Egg, the author of The Birth of the Pill, succinctly said that for as long as men and women have been making babies, they have been trying not to. In the olden days, family planning methods range from the obviously ineffective and to the ridiculously unpleasant. But even with the advent of modern contraceptives and effective family planning, myths and policies still abound, thus imperiling the government's efforts and policies to prevent missed time and unwanted pregnancies, including teenage pregnancies. In the Philippines, it has been documented that toothpaste is being used as a contraceptive. This underscores the relevance and importance of a reproductive health law which is clear, comprehensive, and rights-based. It took us in the Philippines 14 years of struggle to enact a reproductive health law and have the Supreme Court declare it constitutional. But even as we have won in Parliament and in the highest tribunal, now the same institutions are being used by detractors of reproductive health and family planning to stall or even derail the implementation of the law. Like, for example, the slashing of $1 billion from the budget for the purchase of contraceptives and the issuance by the Supreme Court of a continuing, albeit temporary, injunction against the government to acquire and distribute Implanon and Implanon NXT. These are lamentable because central to the implementation of the law is the availability of contraceptives, particularly to the marginalized acceptors in the poorest quintile. The saga is continuing, and the new challenge is the full, immediate, and effective implementation of the law. This Excell Award gives us the impetus in the Philippines for RH advocates to continue the fight, not to put down their guard and not to rest on their laurels. Thank you. Thank you so much for this recognition.
The second Excell Award is the Organization Award. And we give it today to, drum roll. Yayasan Cipta Cara Padu, YCCP, Indonesia. YCCP is an Indonesian organization established by local health leaders and champions to promote progressive health policies and programs. It leads local advocacy initiatives to improve family planning policies and increase support and financial commitments from district, provincial, and national levels. Additionally, it implements programs on behavior change communication, community mobilization, and social marketing. YCCP is a pioneer in advocacy at decentralized levels and provides learnings and best practices to other countries which are also decentralizing. YYC programs have succeeded in increasing district level family planning budgets in Bandung, Bogor, Karawang, and Karanganyar. In Bandung, 271 villages allocated a portion of their village budgets to family planning activities, an achievement that is the first of its kind in the country and that has been replicated in many more local governments. Since 2010, YCCP has continuously advocated for improvement in the family planning environment in Indonesia. Its work exemplifies the theme of this conference to achieve global commitment through local action.
Thank you, Scott.
I forgot to introduce. Here to receive the award is YCCP Chairman Sugiri Sarah Reef.
Thank you again, Scott. It is surprise for me that I represent the YCCP to get the award from Excell. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Yayasan Cipta Cara Padu, or Cipta Cara Padu Foundation, I deeply honor to be here to accept this award. It is really a privilege for us to be recognized by such an amazing organization as Bill and Melinda Gates Institute for Population and Reproductive Health at Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health. So thank you very much for this attention. Our foundation, CCP, has been working for 8 years in more than 136 districts in 13 provinces in Indonesia. We assist to increase the capacity of Indonesian stakeholders in implementing various family planning related programs, including in providing better access for women to improve quality of reproductive health services. We support and work together with anybody and any institution to fulfill our nation's commitment to SDGs and Family Planning 2020. Although we realize that this award has shown a deep appreciation to our achievement, we are sure that there are many things should be done in Indonesia. I would like to send my highest appreciation to all my colleagues in the Cipta Cara Padu Indonesia, who is here right now, Mr. Ishar M. Fihir, Ibu Ina Selvani, who leads the foundation, Dini Tuti, Tri Elvira, and all of AFP and ICMM team. You are actually the winner of this award. This award is the result of your hard work and dedication. Thank you for all of you. I'm sure that this award will make you and I working together harder and harder. I would like also to thanks to Johns Hopkins Center of for Communication Programs in Baltimore and Indonesia, Susan Kern, Alice Payne, Merit, Fitri Pucuk, Harry Hairudin, and the rest of the team for the good collaboration and support. Foremost, we also would like to thanks to Advanced Family Planning Baltimore, especially for Professor Duff and Sarah Whitmarsh. And last but not least, especially thank to Pak Oying. We also want to express gratitude to all of partners, especially our district and province partners, district working group and provincial working group, PKKBN, Pak Chandra, and Ministry of Health, who really are the champions of this family planning. I just assist them. We would not be here without their cooperation and their support. Again, we are really honored to have this award. Very thanks to all of you. And I want to say in this moment that politician, ulama, religious leader, or others could be disagree with family planning or to family planning. However, if you advocate them, I believe they will understand and they will improve their knowledge. Thank you.
The third Excell Award is the Country Award, and today we have two recipients. The first country we recognize is, drumroll. Kenya. Kenya has shown outstanding commitment to family planning on many levels, from the inclusion of family planning as a fundamental right in the Constitution of Kenya to their pioneering work in community-based programs. Kenya has made family planning a priority. Between 2008 and 2015, contraceptive prevalence increased from 32% to 41% and recently reached a high of 58% among married women. Kenya has also continued to reduce the equity gap in contraceptive access and use. The government of Kenya has introduced new policies and initiatives, including free maternity care, which includes family planning, and a new adolescent and youth sexual and reproductive health policy, which has a prominent emphasis on contraceptive access. Kenya has spearheaded innovative service delivery models such as community-based distribution, postpartum family planning, urban reproductive health, working in slum areas, and Implanon NXT rollout. Kenya's dedication and sustained commitment to family planning are truly praiseworthy. Here to receive the award is Dr. Jackson Kioko, Director of Medical Services in the Department of Preventive and Promotive Health Services, Ministry of Health, and he is accompanied by the Honorable Andrew Tobosu, Chair of the Kenya Parliamentarian Group for Population and Reproductive Health.
Thank you very much. Indeed, this is a great and exciting moment for Kenya. We have made it again. We have always done it, and we have made it again. This far we have reached as a country is as a result of hard work, is as a result of passion and strong commitment and partnership with all our development partners, with our National Assembly and the civil society organization and the religious group. This is indeed an exciting moment for country Kenya. Ladies and gentlemen, of course, you know Kenya. You know Kenya. We are a great small nation and a hot belt of heroes. We not only produce world champions in the athletics, but we also produce renowned world leaders. And you know what I mean. As a country, we have made great strides in family planning and reproductive health. We witnessed a CPR growth of 2% annually over the last 5 years. And this is a great achievement for us as a nation. We have also realized a substantial decline in the TFR from the high of 4.6
to 3.9 in 2014. And this is indeed great achievement, great milestones, which calls for celebrations. As a country, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the journey of getting closer each day to the London Summit commitments. And we are determined to get there because we are a country of champions. Indeed, therefore, this afternoon, I'm humbly and deeply honored to receive this Excell Global Award on Leadership on behalf of the people of the Republic of Kenya, and also on behalf of the development partners who have done a tremendous work to support this nation and to achieve these good results. And also the members of parliament who are also here happily to accept and receive this award. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And God bless Kenya. God bless everyone. Thank you very much.
The second Country Excell Award recognizes Ethiopia. Ethiopia is often hailed as a family planning success story. The modern contraceptive prevalence rate has increased dramatically, more than fourfold in just 11 years, from 6% in 2000 to 29% in 2011. Since then, there has continued to be an annual increase of at least 2 points per year in modern contraceptive as monitored through PMA 2020. These are among the most rapid and sustained increases in the world. The federal government of Ethiopia and the Ministry of Health in particular has played a central role in these great achievements by extending services to rural and underserved areas. The deployment of the health extension workers and task sharing initiatives that train providers to safely insert implants has played a major role in expanding access and choice to family planning information and services. Commendable leadership from the Maternal and Child Health Directorate through the prioritization of family planning, expansion of services, the learning agenda, and evidence-based programming and policymaking has made such success possible. We applaud Ethiopia as a model of family planning success. And here to receive the award is the Minister of Health, Dr. Kasete Biran Admasu.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon. So as you can see, the athletics rivalry between Ethiopia and Kenya continues here again. We are delighted to receive this award. We have received an award in the third ICFP conference in Addis. This is the second time Ethiopia is being recognized as a champion in family planning. And we hope in sporting terms to do a hat trick next time as well. Ethiopia is a much safer and better place for women and children today than 10 years ago, 15 years ago. Our commitment to our people, to our women and children, will continue over the next years until Ethiopia is one of the model countries in the world. The commitment and the results the country has registered over the last two decades is as a result of political commitment from the government, the engagement and the unprecedented support we have enjoyed from our development partners, and above all, the commitment, determination, and hard work of our health workers. I would like to pay special tribute to our community health extension workers who work tirelessly every day, walking for hours, reaching every woman in the country to give them information, to give them knowledge, skill, to empower them, and as well as to provide services. This would not have been possible without the hard work of our health workers. I just would like to say thank you, thank you, thank you to all our health workers, and thank you for the award.
So please join me in congratulating all of the Excell Award winners 2016.